हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द टॉपिक बायोटेक्नोलॉजी. मायसेल्फ प्रोफेसर शिल्पा राव फ्रॉम केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी नासिक. सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली दिस एंजाइम टेक्नोलॉजी एंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली द एंजाइम. एंजाइम इज अ बायोलॉजिकल कैटलिस्ट दैट प्रमोट्स एंड स्पीड अप्स द केमिकल रिएक्शन without itself being altered in the process. They fulfill their role by binding specific substrate at the active site. This for the enhancement of the different biochemical reaction within the body, these enzymes are used. They are made up of the amino acids which are linked together via peptide bond in a linear chain. Enzyme biotechnology is concerned with the production, isolation, purification and use of enzymes. Means all these processes coming under the enzyme technology. Value of using enzyme over inorganic catalyst in the technological field is due to their efficiency, selectivity and specificity. Because of these three reasons, enzymes are preferred instead of the inorganic catalyst for the different chemical reaction. This is lock and key model of enzyme. Enzyme entered at the active site for the then enzyme changes shape slightly as substrate bind, then the substrate get converted into the product and then product is released from the enzyme. This is the general mechanism of action of the enzyme. Now commercial production of enzyme. The first enzyme produced industrially was ticadiesterase in 1896 in US to cure digestive disorder. Ticadiesterase is the fungal amylase. A German scientist Otto Rohn demonstrated in 1905 extract from animal organ, that is pancreas from pig and cow. Source of enzyme protease for leather softening. Okay, means this is the second invention in the enzyme biotechnology. Isolation of the enzyme from the pig and cow pancreas. That enzyme was protease and this protease was used in the softening of the leather. The utilization of enzyme for laundry purpose stated in 1950, it was not continued due to allergic reaction of impurities of enzyme. Now again this protease is used in the laundry purpose, but because of the allergic reaction there is no further use of this protease in the laundry purpose. Then different organisms and their relative contribution for commercial production of enzyme. About 60% fungal species are used for the enzyme production, then 24% bacteria, 4% yeast, then 2% streptomyces, then 6% higher animal and 4% higher plants are used for the commercial production of the enzyme. But in a large amount microorganisms are used. These are the major sources. Plant 4%, then animal 8% and microorganism more than 80%, yeast, fungi and bacterial species. Then commercial production of enzyme from plant sources and their application. Beta amylase obtained from the barley and soybean used in a baking industry or in for the bakery product product, then preparation of the maltose syrup, then bromelain obtained from the pineapple, also used for the baking purpose, then esterase obtained from the wheat, used in the ester hydrolysis, then ficin obtained from pig, that is used for the meat tenderization, then papain from papaya, used for the meat tenderization, tanning and baking, then peroxidase obtained from horseradish, used for the diagnostic purpose, then urease obtained from jack bean, used for the diagnostic purpose. Commercially produced enzyme from animal sources and their application. Okay, then amylase and esterase obtained from lamb and calf, used for the digestive purpose. Then pepsin, trypsin obtained from bovine, used for the preparation of cheese. Then lipase and renin, then phospholipase and phytase obtained from porcine. Then lysozyme obtained from hen egg and used for the cell wall breakage of the bacteria. This lysozyme is most commonly used for the breakdown of the bacterial cell wall. Then human urine, urokinase is obtained and for it is used for the dissolution of the blood clot. Then we'll see why the microorganisms are used more than 80% as compared to the plants and animals. What are the reasons behind this use? There are several drawbacks associated with manufacture of enzyme from animal and plant source. The quantities are limited and there is a wide variation in their distribution. Then most important limitation are difficulty in isolating, purifying the enzyme and cost factor. As regards extraction of the industrial enzyme from bovine sources, there is a heavy risk of contamination with bovine spongiform encephalopathy, that is the neurological disorder in cattle. These are the reasons why we are using the microorganism, why we are not using this plant and animal. Means amount of parts of plant or parts of animal are required in large amount and your yield is very less percent. That's why there is a limitation to use of these higher plants and animals. Then again, second thing is difficulties in isolating and purifying the enzyme from plant and animal sources. This is the second thing or second limitation. For these reason, microbial production of enzyme is preferred. Microorganisms are the most significant and convenient source of the commercial enzyme. They can produce abundant quantities of enzyme under suitable growth condition. Microorganism can be cultivated by using inexpensive media and production can take place in a short period. Okay, means life cycle of the microorganism is very short. That's why within short period of time we can produce large amount of the enzyme. Then again, size of this microorganism is very very microscopic. That's why the storage and handling is very easy as compared to the higher plant and higher animal. Again, media required for the growth of this microorganism is inexpensive. In addition, it is easy to manipulate microorganism in genetic engineering technique to increase the production of desired enzyme. Okay, means genetic manipulation can be done very easily in the microorganism and we can improve the yield of a particular enzyme. Then the recovery, isolation and purification process are easy with microbial enzyme than that with animal or plant sources. In fact, most enzyme of the industrial application have been successfully produced by microorganism. Various fungi bacteria and yeasts are employed for this purpose. List of enzyme along with these microbial sources. Then the technology of the enzyme production. We'll see the general steps in the enzyme production. In general, this technique employed for the microbial production of enzyme are comparable to the methods used for the manufacture of other industrial products. The salient features are briefly described. Steps involved in this enzyme production. First is selection of microorganism, then formulation of medium, then production process, and last one, recovery and purification of the enzyme. If preserved inoculum, we have to subculture it and develop the inoculum suitable for your production process, means in the suitable amount. Then we have to inoculate into the tank. This tank which consists of the suitable culture medium for the growth of this microorganism. Then you have to fill all the content in fermenter. Then cell disruption is there, means after completion of the fermentation process, cell disruption is there, then filtration is there, then removal of the nucleic acid. These are the recovery processes. Then salt treatment, then cool storage, then again filtration, final purification, freeze drying, and you have your enzyme in the form of powder. This is the outline of the enzyme production by the microorganism. The first step is the selection of microorganism. Important criteria for selecting the microorganism are: the organism should produce the maximum quantity of desired enzyme in short time, while the amount of other metabolite produced are minimal. One of the organism is selected, strain improved for optimizing the enzyme production can be done by appropriate methods. From the organisms chosen, inoculum can be prepared in a liquid medium. Okay, means first criteria is the organism should have the capability to produce large amount of particular enzyme. Second is the formulation of medium. Now you have selected microorganism with you. Now we have to select the proper medium for the growth of that microorganism. The culture medium chosen should contain all the nutrients to support adequate growth of microorganism that will ultimately result in good quantities of enzyme production. The ingredients of the medium should be readily available at low cost and are nutritionally safe from microorganism point of view. Some of the commonly used substrate for the medium, that is starch hydrolysate, yeast extract, then whey and wheat extract, then soybean meal. These are the different examples of the substrate used into the medium. Then some cereals and pulses have also been used. pH of the medium kept optimum for good microbial growth and enzyme production. Means as per your selected microorganism, you have to decide the pH of the medium and accordingly you have to maintain it at the higher side. Production process. Industrial production of enzyme is mostly carried out by submerged liquid condition and to a lesser extent by solid substrate fermentation. These are the two techniques used for the large scale production of the enzyme, that is solid substrate fermentation and submerged liquid condition. Submerged liquid condition means you have to mix your inoculum into the liquid medium, liquid growth medium, and then there is a production of the enzyme, and then you have to purify it and you have to isolate it and you have to purify it. But in case of solid substrate fermentation, you have to spread your microorganism on the solid surface. Your media is in the form of solid. This is the difference between the submerged liquid and solid substrate fermentation. Now, in submerged culture technique, the yield are more and the chances of infection are less. Hence, this is preferred method. Along with this advantage, one more advantage is that it is easy to mix all the ingredients along with inoculum. Then we can adjust the pH, we can adjust the temperature, because its movement is very easy. With the help of baffle, you can move all the content within the fermenter. But this is not the case for the solid substrate fermentation. We can't mix it properly because already it is in the form of solid. Solid substrate fermentation is historically important and still in use for the production of fungal enzyme. Example, amylase, cellulases, protease and pectinase. The medium can be sterilized, batch or continuous sterilization technique. Then fermentation, inoculating the medium, the growth condition, pH, temperature, then oxygen supply, nutrient addition are maintained at the optimal level. Then froth formation can be minimized by addition of anti-foaming agent. The production of enzyme is mostly carried out by batch fermentation and to lesser extent by the continuous process. Batch fermentation means you have to take the suitable amount of inoculum, you have to take the suitable amount of medium, then you have to keep it into the fermenter, then allow to keep it for the particular period of time. Then you have to start with the isolation and purification. No in between addition of inoculum and addition of medium is there. You have to complete that fermentation process of particular batch and then you have to go for the isolation and purification. But in case of continuous process, there might be the addition of nutrient in between the fermentation process and removal of the product or removal of the you can say enzyme in between the fermentation process is there. That's why it is known as the continuous process. Within this continuous process, addition of the medium is there and removal of the product is there. Means it is the continuous process, but it is not the case for the batch fermentation. The bioreactor system must be maintained sterile throughout the fermentation process and duration of the fermentation is variable around 2 to 7 days in most production processes. Then fourth step is the recovery and purification of the enzyme. The desired enzyme produced may be excreted into the culture medium, extracellular enzyme, or it may be present within the cell, that is the intracellular enzyme. The recovery and purification step employed will depend on the nature of the enzyme and degree of the purity desired. Means on the basis of these two things, we have to decide the recovery process. Recovery of an extracellular enzyme which is present in a broth is relatively simpler as compared to the intracellular enzyme. For the release of intracellular enzyme, special techniques are needed for the cell disruption. Means if your enzyme is secreted intracellularly, then disruption of the cell is required, and for this disruption process, different techniques are used. For example, sonication, high pressure, then glass beads. These are used as the physical agent for the breakdown of the cell. Then certain enzymes are also used, for example lysozymes, you can say them chemical method for the breakdown of the bacterial cell wall or the bacterial cell.
Then for yeast, the enzyme beta glucanase is used, and enzymatic methods are expensive as compared to the physical method. The recovery and purification step will be same for both intracellular and extracellular enzyme. Once the cell are disrupted, the intracellular enzyme are released, and most important consideration is to minimize loss of desired enzyme activity. Means during this recovery and purification process, enzyme should not lose its potency, lose its activity. Then removal of debris by using the filtration and centrifugation, removal of the nucleic acid by the precipitation, and removed by adding the polycation, for example polyamine, streptomycin and polyethylamine. Then enzyme precipitation by using salt, for example ammonium sulfate. Then organic solvents are also used for the precipitation process, for example propanenol, then ethanol and acetone. Then liquid-liquid partition using polyethylene glycol or polyamine. Then separation by chromatography. In the chromatography, ion exchange, size exclusion, then affinity, hydrophobic interaction, and dye-ligand chromatographic techniques are used. And most preferably used technique is ion exchange chromatography. Then drying and packing. The concentrated form of the enzyme can be obtained by drying film evaporator or freeze dryer. It is also known as the lyophilizer. The dried enzyme can be packed and marketed. All the enzymes used in food or medical treatments must be of high grade purity and must meet the required specification of the regulatory bodies. Means as per the requirement of the regulatory bodies, your enzyme should have purity, it should have high grade purity as per the regulatory guideline. Factors affecting on the enzyme activity in the cell, that is concentration of enzyme and substrate. The rate of reaction increases with increase in the substrate concentration up to a point beyond which any further increase in substrate concentration produces no significant changes in a reaction rate. This occurs because after a certain concentration of substrate, all the active sites on the enzyme are full and no further reaction can occur. Okay, all of you know the substrate bind with the enzyme and then it converted into the product. But as the initial state, if you increase the concentration of substrate, then there is a continuous increase in the product. But up to which level? Up to the saturation of the enzyme. As your enzyme is totally saturated, then there is no further increase in the reaction as you are increasing the concentration of substrate, because enzyme sites are full. Second factor is temperature. With increase of temperature, enzyme activity increases because increases the kinetic energy of the molecule. All of you know the temperature is responsible for the kinetic activity of the molecule. There is an optimum level when enzyme work at best and maximum. This temperature is often the normal body temperature. When temperature increases beyond a certain limit, enzymes which are actually made up of the protein begin to disintegrate and rate of reaction slows down. Okay, means as the temperature increases, enzyme activity is also increases, but up to the body temperature level. Okay, all of you know these enzymes are made up of the proteins, and protein undergo the coagulation at the higher temperature. That's why you should not exceed the temperature up to the coagulation. Enzymes are very sensitive to changes in a pH, and work in a very small window of permissible pH level. Below or above the optimal pH level, there is a risk of enzyme disintegrating and thereby reaction slows down. Means we have to maintain the proper pH range according to the nature of your microorganism, which will give you the higher yield, which was the suitable pH for the high yield. Then inhibitors, presence of certain substances that inhibit the action of particular enzyme. These occur when inhibiting substance attached itself to the active site of enzyme, thereby preventing the substrate attachment and slowing down the process. Okay, means instead of substrate, some inhibitor bind with the enzyme and there is a no conversion of substrate to product. Means as the concentration of inhibitor increases, ultimately you will not get your product. Okay, this is all about the enzyme biotechnology. Thank you.